Hi everyone, Shell here, and today I'm making some adorable Batman cookies for my little cousin's third birthday. So I thought I would share these with you. If you enjoy things like this, stick around and watch me decorate them. And don't forget, if you haven't already, make sure you hit the subscribe button and the notifications bell so you'll be notified when I upload more tasty treats like this in the future. So let's make some Batman cookies. So I started with this recipe of no spread sugar cookies. They are vanilla flavored, but also with a hint of almond to give them just that extra touch of great flavor. And I will include the recipe in the description, but I rolled them out between parchment paper. I like to chill mine that way. And then once they were chilled, I just took my 4-inch circle cutter and just cut the cookies out and just re-rolled, you know, what I had left over, and just continued to cut out some more till I had used up all my dough. And now I'm gonna just get them on a pan and get them ready to go in the oven. And I'm gonna bake these on 350 degrees for about 10 minutes. Cookies are now baked and out of the oven. And I actually got 18 from this recipe, but I only need 12 for the Batman cookies. It's always good to have a few extra, you know, just in case you mess some up. Now I have a Batman cutter that I purchased quite a while back for my cakes. So what I did is took this and turned it upside down on top of the cookie. And then I just took my black edible marker and just traced out my bat to put on the cookies, so as a guideline. So now here I'm taking my black royal icing and just outlining the bat. And I like to outline each one, and that way it gives it a little time for that royal icing to stiffen a bit. And then I'm going back and I'll start filling in the bats. And once I've got all these filled in, then of course, you know, I will let them set for about 30 minutes or so, just so they start forming a crust over the icing before I go back in with the yellow that's going to be on the remainder of the cookie. And of course, I did make both an outline consistency for this as well as a flood consistency in the black to fill in the bats. I will also include that royal icing recipe in the description as well. And here I have actually went around again with a piping consistency or a stiff consistency with yellow, and also a flood consistency. And I've went around and you can see I've outlined all of the cookies with the yellow and then went back and started filling in. I will say, you know, cookies aren't my specialty, but I do enjoy making them and just getting better with them all the time. So starting out, my flood consistency could have been a little thinner, and I kind of realized that, you know, as I struggled a little bit and got closer to the end of the cookies. And I did end up going in and thinning it out just a little more for the last few. So the last few you'll see are you know, a bit smoother than the rest, probably in hindsight, I would have done the yellow on the cookie and then just went back and done the black on that on top versus doing it this way. I just think it would have been a bit of a nicer look, although they did come out very cute in the end, and you know, I was very pleased with them. Let me know what you think about them in the comments. Here we go, they are all done. And again, like I said, just let me know what you think about them in the comments. I love hearing from everybody. And if you did enjoy the video, make sure you give it a thumbs up. And if you haven't already, make sure you hit the subscribe button and the notifications bell so you'll be notified when I upload more videos in the future. And again, I thank everyone for your wonderful support. And I look forward to next time. Thank you.